Hey everybody, Adam Bobrow here with another episode of Ask a Pro Anything, presented by Andro, the at-home edition. And with us, we've got two boys that you might know, the leading men of the British boys. It is Liam Pitchford and Paul Drinkhall. How you guys doing?
Good, thanks. How are you?
I'm also good, thanks. It's been a little while since I've seen you both. I guess Qatar, right?
Yeah, definitely.
So yeah, how have you been keeping?
A video call these days, but it's about as close contact as you get.
I've been good, thanks. I've been at home for the most part. Had an adventure last week going back to the US briefly, and other than that, I'm on home.
Was that for the recording of the trick shots? And so, yeah, I watched the video last night. It looked amazing.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I felt I was very happy with it. I think anyone who knows table tennis well knows that I would never call myself a table tennis professional and was a little embarrassed about it. But I realized that, it's for something like that. It's not a big deal. Just know that I know.
That's good.
Thanks. Good times, good times. What's so where are you guys right now? Paul, how about
you? Me, I'm in my little man's bedroom.
In what place?
In England, outskirts of London, enjoying the beautiful weather.
Wait, you let your son live in the outskirts of London?
Yep.
You drove to your son's home in the outskirts of London to go use his...
He's five, so he's growing up now, so he needs his own space.
No, independence is important. I think if you haven't learned independence by four, you're behind the curve.
Yeah.
For sure.
So I don't have a computer, so he's let me use his computer and things, so it's really kind of him.
No, that's cool. Yeah, kids and their technology, they got to help their dads out these days. Keep calm and use your son's stuff. That's what the job said. Pitch, how about you? Where are you at right now?
Also in the UK, slightly more north than Paul, like Nottingham area.
Can you guys see each other if you like turn sideways right now? So family life, let's start with you, Paul, just because you're in your boy's room. Tell us a little bit about, you know, I think you married your high school sweetheart, a doubles partner, and how many kids? How old are they? What's the story for you right now?
Putting me on the spot here, aren't you, Adam? I've got two children, and it's with my wife Joanna Drinkhall, used to be Parker, who played. Remembered. That's great. My eldest is 5 year old. This is his room. Little named Dougie. A little character, and our youngest is three, called Bonnie. Two Scottish names, don't really know why, there's no Scottish in us, but we liked the name and went with it. And as strange as the this time has been recently, it's given me a lot more time at home, and I mean consecutive nights at home has been ridiculous. Like I've not had that, I think, since I was probably 15, which obviously not for a very good reason, but it's been really good and used it as a positive in that way. And it's been in that way, it's been really amazing for me and the family to spend some really good time together. And our eldest has started reception now, so that's school every day. So once he'd started that, I started to think I won't spend much time with him now. And when I get home, even when I'm home, he'll be out most of the day. I'll only have a couple of hours in the evening. So when I'm only home for 2 or 3 days, don't really see him a lot at all. But again, with this, there's been a lot of positives in that way. And spent some really good quality time together, which has been good.
Nice.
Sorry, I'm boring pitch there. He's yawning away. And...
I wasn't yawning.
Hey guys, I'll go on for you both.
Morning everybody. We just started
early morning. We had to fit to Adam's timetable, so it's early morning. No, I'm joking.
Early morning, yeah.
Yeah. How about you, Pete? What's up happening with you lately?
What's happening with me?
Personal life.
What, my personal life?
He's grown his beard for 3 months during lockdown, as you can tell.
That looks like you could light a match.
I tell you, you could. No, obviously been a bit of a weird situation, hasn't it? But like Paul said, been at home for the longest time, probably since I started playing table tennis, I think. So it's been good to have some time at home, but you know, nice to get back into practice now. Been playing a bit of golf, yeah, getting out on the golf course, but yeah, my partner, we've been together what, 5 years, 5 and a bit years now, so we're getting married next year. Yeah.
No pressure there from Adam.
Hello. So yeah, nope. Everything's good, but I'm looking forward to getting back out on the tour soon.
Wow. Well, from pitch on the pitch to pitch back on the world tour, I think we're all excited to see each other. And whether you're playing at the highest level like you guys or watching, calling it, or just watching from home, we're all very excited to be able to see our favorite athletes competing again. Do you guys already have a date set?
Yeah. I can't reveal that yet, but
I respect
not until next year. So,
okay.
With everything going on, it's give it some time.
Yeah, for sure. Take your time. We'll be excited to know more. Time is right.
You'll be waiting for the invite, won't you, Adam?
Yeah.
not only will I be waiting, I'm going to crash it if I'm not invited. Show up, whatever you're wearing, I'm going to wear the exact same thing, and I'm going to write groom on the back, and I'm just going to try to break in, and when they say speak now or forever hold your peace, if they say that, I'm going to speak. No, I don't know.
I'm looking forward to it.
Oh, good. Okay, I'll do it. So you said getting back into practice. How long have you been practicing again now, Pitch?
When did we go back for? About early July?
Early 7th of July, something like that. Early June?
June, maybe, yeah.
Was it?
So maybe.
We don't know.
I think it was early, middle of June-ish, probably.
Okay, so a good month and a half or more.
Yeah, so we had through our Table Tennis England and through the sort of Olympic Association and together with badminton, they had a hall, so they put on the a table up for us in a room, and we had to have sort of all the precautions and everything. We had to get tested before we went into the hall. We could only have two players in the hall, so I mean it was a bit different practice than usual, but it was good to get back on the table really. And now things are starting to relax a little bit more, so I went for a week training in Copenhagen a couple of weeks ago, and now we've got a different hall now in the UK, so it's a bit more free practice. We can do more multi-ball with our coaches now, so it's getting better.
I had a few questions for you. I think I saw your post on social media about flying during these times. For me, it was quite fascinating. What was your experience like flying right now?
It was weird. Like having to wear a mask all the time, kind of, I don't know, I feel a bit claustrophobic in it, you know, when you have to wear it throughout the whole flight. But I think for me that, like, the airports were still fairly busy, so it's a bit strange to say. I think when I went, everyone was just being allowed to go back to like Spain and that on holiday, so you know, us Brits love to go to Spain.
And Paul, when was the last time you flew?
Back from Qatar, I went to Germany that weekend, and then I came home from Germany, and I think that was the last time. So when was that, March?
Yeah.
So it's gonna be interesting when the time comes again to fly, and hopefully it's like Pitch said, hopefully it's soon, and we can get back to it. But at the minute, I can't really see that. But yeah. Who knows? Who knows?
And Pitch, you said you had to get tested. What type of test did you do before going back into practice?
Every morning we came before practice, we just had to get sort of temperature checked. And, if we had symptoms, we obviously have to get an actual corona test. Luckily, had to do one yet. Yeah, I think Sam and Tom did one. They said it wasn't.
Yeah, I did one the other week as well.
Tickler?
Up the nose, back of the throat, and then up the nose. I mean, it's a bit of uncomfort, isn't it? But it's nothing compared to what some people have gone through. So, I forgot we're going to Dusseldorf, aren't we, Pitch? So we're going to Dusseldorf later in this month. But again, Gavin Evans, the coach from England, he's driving. So I'll just be jumping in the car with him. So last I heard, he is, unless has he changed his mind, has he?
I think so. I don't think it would work driving through three different countries. Really.
Cheers for letting me know, Gav.
I don't know what you've decided.
Well, this is all very fascinating. I've got some questions for you from fans today. We're also going to have a quiz. I don't know if you guys have already seen some of the others competing in the head-to-head quiz battles, but we'll be keeping score going back and forth. Before that, we'll have a few fan questions.
Are we on a team for the quiz or against the others?
The opposite. That divide between your screens that I see right now that maybe isn't the same for you would act as a net, and you guys will be on opposite sides of the table.
All right.
We've got to fire it back, have we?
It'll be competitive.
All right.
A little serve and receive in the quiz game. But first, I want to ask some questions from the fans. So the first question is a question that you can both answer. Sky Guy Spams wants to know, who has the hardest serve to return? Paul, let's start with you.
The hardest serve to return, sorry.
Yeah.
Oof. I think we touched on this on our show, didn't we, Pitch? But I think sort of outright serve to receive could potentially be Per Gorell from Sweden. Just the amount of spin he gets on it is quite incredible. So I think just outright serve, definitely him. But then overall package, so you're scared for everything that comes afterwards. I would say Xu Xing is probably the one, because he's got great serves. And then, the next ball can really finish the point as well.
Yeah. How about you, Pitch?
Well, I'm actually going to say the exact same thing. So cheers, Paul.
That's 1-0 to me, is it? 1-0 to me,
I think I definitely, agree with the outright serve. I definitely say Per Gorell. I think just for, it is very difficult to read, especially if you've never played him before. But again, sort of, I've played Xu Xing a few times and, struggled to stop him attacking. And for me, that's a sign of a very good serve. And he's got so much variation, and it's very difficult to stop him getting in with that third ball. So I'd say him as well.
Cool. Second question here. This one is for Paul specifically. It comes from trick shot artist Table Tennis Brack. How did you control your nerves against Xu Xing when you had match points?
So that's for Pitch, I guess. Do you know what? I think what he's talking about, when we resume, he's seen the future, this guy. But I'll come back to that one. I'll let Pitch answer it for now.
Sounds good. Pitch, how about you?
I think for me, obviously in Qatar, I was playing really well. And I kind of had nothing to lose against Xu Xing. When it was 3-2-9-all, I could feel he was under pressure. He was nervous. And I said to myself, just go for your shots, play your game. And I think at 9-all, I got in with two sort of half-long spins. And, he missed the next ball. And I think that's what I had to tell myself, you can play the rallies with these guys, the Chinese. I think a lot of people are scared to get into rallies with them, whereas at that time, in Qatar, I kind of said to myself, you're playing well enough, you can just play the rallies with them, push long and then take the next ball on, which is what I did. And it kind of worked out. Maybe it wouldn't have worked out some other times, but there it did. And I mean, obviously I was nervous, but, you know, the pressure was on him, I think, at that time.
Did that help keep you calm and say, sort of just stick with the plan? You've been doing it the whole match. You don't need to change anything.
Yeah. I mean, I kept doing my thing, just playing my game. I tried to find his backhand as much as I could. Gavin in the corner was quite a calming influence in that match. I think you touched on it, what he was saying in the corner, because I think you could hear that. He was just telling me to believe in myself and just play my game and relax and be free. And I managed to do that in that match.
Sure did. Cool to hear. What are you thinking, Paul?
Great stuff.
Wise words.
This is hilarious. I think I'd like to say that you guys encouraged me, but this is by far the most sarcastic Ask a Pro Anything in the history of any of it.
We're just getting started, aren't we, Adam?
Sure. Where's the tea?
Mine's gone now.
Yeah, mine is. Mine's to get
my son's coffee service isn't very good, is it?
Coffee. So we're about to get into the competitive situation now. I'll have two more questions for you guys later. But now it's going to be quiz time. First question is to Paul. Question number one, general table tennis knowledge. Who did Jan Ove Waldner get beaten by in the final of the 1991 Men's Singles World Table Tennis Championships?
I know this one.
Liu Guoliang.
Final answer, Liu Guoliang?
Yeah.
It was Jürgen Persson.
Persson. Okay.
Good to know, though. Good to know.
Tailton's history, I'm terrible. Did Gatian win the world?
Yeah, 93.
Okay. He was my other answer, so it was good that it wasn't him.
That's true. That is true. All righty. So we're moving on. Now it is 0-0 tied up, and Pitch, a chance to take the early lead.
I'm scared now because I knew that one, and now I'm going to get a hard one.
That'd be hilarious if you guys both know each other's answers the whole way through, but get zero. All right, here we go, Pitch. Who won the men's singles title at this year's World Tour season opener, the 2020 ITTF World Tour German Open?
Fan Zhendong.
It was not Fan Zhendong. It was Xu Xin. Paul, did you know that?
Yeah, of course I did, yeah.
Convincing statement. Tied up at 0-0. The plot thickens. We move on to the second question. Paul, England won the men's team title at the 2002 Commonwealth Games. Which team did they beat in the final?
Singapore. Singapore.
It was not Singapore, it was Nigeria.
Nigeria, okay.
This is embarrassing.
I was actually there as well. That's what's funny about that.
you're like, I was actually there playing for Nigeria at the time and I forgot. Yeah.
Somehow I just managed to slip my mind. That was a good question.
So far, 0 Pitch, your chance to be 1-for-2 with a 50% average. Here we go. In what year did London last play host to the ITTF World Tour Grand Finals?
2011.
Ding, ding, ding. That is correct.
That's correct, because it was the Olympic Games test event.
Well.
What?
It was the Olympic Games test event. I lost to Wang Ao.
Yeah, it's still grand finals, mate.
Yeah, I know. Easy one for him there, Adam.
Yeah.
Think you would have gotten that one, Paul?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Well, we'll see. A chance to catch up.
Well, I played in it, so if I didn't, then I really am losing my mind.
You were there at the one before, and you didn't get that one, so far.
Yeah, but I was 12 years old and watching then, probably, you know, eating sweets or something, talking to somebody about politics in the crowd.
You still do that.
Yeah, I know. That's why I still have no idea what's going on, Adam.
That's why I love sitting and talking with you at matches. But now it'll be a chance for you to tie it up. So, third question. This is for you, Paul. Down 0-1 in points. Personal knowledge. In which year did Liam break into the Senior World Top 20 for the first time?
Hmm. 2019.
2018. Very close. December of 2018, he became world ranked number 16.
Paul, I didn't know whether it was the back end of that year or early 19.
It was a good guess and a tough question. Fair, good guess, but still no fruits for your labor. Rich, up 1-0, your third question, a chance to come up with a commanding lead early on. Personal knowledge. Which player did Paul defeat to win his first World Tour singles gold at the 2014 Spanish Open?
Masataka Morizono.
That is correct. Pitch 2-0. Sharp starts.
Did he pronounce that right?
Not only did he pronounce it right, he pronounced it perfectly.
Ah, there we go. That's only time spent in Japan, lads.
Look at him now. Look at how relaxed he is now.
Maybe you can tap into some of that here as well, Paul, for your fourth question. Down 0-2.
If you asked me that, I'd have probably got it wrong. Sorry, go on.
Say it again.
If you'd have asked me that same question, I'd have probably got it wrong.
Well, that's fortunate that we didn't ask you that for your chances here. All right. Here we go, Paul, on the fourth question. Liam guided England to a first-ever singles medal at the Commonwealth Games. Which city did he achieve that feat in?
Glasgow.
Correct. It was Glasgow. Paul, welcome to the scoreboard. Paul, strong. Only down by one. We can
see. Surprised you got it because he was there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
That usually doesn't seem to help too much. All right. So, Pitch, still up 2-1 right now. A chance to break open early on.
Tough question coming in, Pitch. I've got it.
Let's see. How many times has Paul been English national singles champion?
Six.
Do you want to just give him a point here or what?
Correct. Pitch, 3-1.
Do I get that question about Pitch?
I'm just curious. So I'll ask you for fun. How many times has Pitch been English national champion?
Six. That's why it's easy.
Liam recorded a semifinal win over Xu Xin at the 2020 ITTF World Tour Platinum Qatar Open. Which other Chinese star did Liam famously topple at the 2018 Bulgaria Open?
Malong.
Correct. Do you remember who you were sitting next to when it happened?
No, I've erased that from my memory.
Are you serious?
Is he ever
look
serious?
At his face.
He's being serious.
Okay, good times.
Of yes. Course I remember, Adam.
Thank you. That was precious for me, too.
I feel like you gave me easy questions.
Yeah, Pitch, we were sitting next to each other watching that as it all unfolded, so it was very fascinating and entertaining for us to watch you pull that off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's not bothered about that now. He wants his next question.
Yeah.
He's like, give me an easy one.
Okay. That's right. 3-2. A lead for Pitch. Here we go. In which country did Paul claim his first ITTF Challenge Series gold in 2019?
Serbia.
Correct. It is Serbia. So 4-2, the lead still up by 2. Pitch, Paul, it's your chance now to try and get within one. How old was Liam when he made his first world individual championships? Let me re-ask that. How old was Liam when he made his world individual championships debut?
He doesn't know that. 17. Senior, right?
Or 16. Final answer.
What are you saying, Paul?
Final answer?
What did you say, Adam? Sorry, what am I trying to do here?
How old was I?
17.
Correct.
But I don't know where 16 came from. I didn't say 16.
I wasn't looking at your face, but I heard it, and it sounded like...
All right, okay.
That's so weird. Maybe,
yeah.
17, okay. Three it's to four.
Total guess.
It was
did you know that pitch?
Yeah, it's 2011.
Okay.
Yeah, so I was soon close to being 18.
That's true. Okay.
You were 17, right? So I got it right.
Also true.
You got pitch. Your answer.
4-3, pitch. Here we go. Last of the personal knowledge question. Last of the personal knowledge questions. Which round did Paul reach on his Olympic singles debut at London 2012?
Last 32.
Correct. So pitch with 5 points. Paul still down by 2 as we get into the general knowledge section. Master Chief is a fictional character and protagonist in which famous video game franchise?
Red Dead Redemption. I have no idea.
It is not the Shawshank Redemption, but good. Yeah, just kidding. It is. Pitch, do you know?
I don't know. Tekken?
Halo is the answer. Halo.
No. Halo?
That's Xbox.
Yeah, don't play Halo.
Okay. Here we go.
Wrong console, Adam.
Wrong console.
Like, Paul, PlayStation.
I know. I'd have a slight chance at PlayStation, but Xbox is zero.
Atari, Nintendo 64. That's what I got. All right.
Good.
Good times, good times. All right, pitch.
Nervous, no.
Still up 5-3. Which country has the smallest population in Africa?
Oh.
Botswana.
Botswana? It is not Botswana. You would have accepted Seychelles or Seychelles, depending on how you prefer to say it.
I was going to say that, but didn't know how to pronounce it, so I went with an easier one.
That's definitely the way to go. That's definitely the way to go.
That was a harsh one, that was.
Who came up with that question?
I think...
If you get that one right.
I think everybody. We had like 5 people who just sort of casually were talking about it, and they were like, oh, we should ask that question.
Yeah.
All right. General knowledge. We are moving back over. Paul, still down by 2 at 3-5. What is the largest living animal in the world?
Elephant.
It is not an elephant. It is the blue whale.
Oh, yeah, but yeah. All right.
Blue whale. Yes, they eat elephants for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. No. But they are upwards of 100 feet, 30 meters
yeah,
long.
Yeah, no, blue whale was my first thought, but then I just thought that it might be a trick question.
Yeah.
Land animal, but anyway.
I hope we make a compilation of all your excuses and just time together.
No, it's the way my brain works. It's not excuses. It's just literally the way my little pea brain works.
I like it. That was cool. I like what your forehead did there. That was neat. Can we see that one more time, Paul?
Yeah.
No. If I get a point for it.
Editors, replay, slow-mo. So, Liam, this is your chance to break open to a 3-point lead, doubling the score of your opponent as we get into the business end of the game. So... who was the first actor to portray British spy agent James Bond?
Oh my gosh. Roger Moore.
It's not Roger Moore, it was Sean Connery.
Is he the first, was he?
Yeah.
I tell you what, they're trying to get me to catch up here, aren't they, Pitch, with these questions?
I know.
But a good guess.
I'm good about that.
Definitely a good guess. All right. So it is Paul's chance. Still down 3-5. A frozen scoreboard. Can you thaw it? Can you melt the ice block that is your scoreboard? Paul.
How many questions we got left? Sorry.
Got two questions left.
Ooh.
This is the second to the last one for you. Here we go. Which team beat England to the 2019 Rugby World Cup title in Japan?
Can I have these questions, please?
Ireland.
South Africa. South Africa. Good times. Any thoughts?
Again, yeah, I watched it. I did. Rubbish game of rugby. England just couldn't get through them because they're a wall. Is that right, Pitch? Like, they just play boring rugby, but they played right tactics. I remember, now you've said it, I remember watching them.
Tactically, well, yeah.
Yeah, very good tactically, but yeah.
Did the same in the semis. Watched.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Liam just got sponsored by the rugby team. Very diplomatic answer. I like it. Okay. Pitch. Still up 5-3. It's been a while since anyone's scored.
Right. Since we came across the general knowledge.
All right. Wolverine, Cyclops, and Storm are all members of which superhero group?
The X-Men.
Correct. The X-Men. Pitch. 6. Paul. 3.
That's one I would have got. About the only one in the whole quiz that I actually knew. Even the ones I've got, most of them, I suppose, now Glasgow. I knew that one.
Yeah.
The other two were guesses.
I love hearing you guys talk your way out of this. It's the best. All right.
Can't talk your way out of 3 points, Adam. It's fact.
You are 1 point away from tying yourself up with the person who is right now second from the bottom of the leaderboard. So, here we go, Paul. A chance for you. Is that right? Or are we Liam's turn? No, it is Paul's.
Me.
Okay.
Depends what the question is, Adam.
I'm lightheaded from all the laughing. Good point. All right, here we go. Paul, who holds the world record for the 100-meter sprint?
Usain Bolt.
Correct.
Usain.
Just felt sorry for him there, didn't you?
He felt sorry for me with the blue whale. I can't believe I got that one wrong, if I'm honest. But
I don't write the questions, I just read them. But Paul, congratulations on your fourth point. You have a chance to be, well, let's just watch and enjoy what Pitch does to see if he gets 7. Pitch, final question, a chance to be one of the top on the leaderboard. How many Grand Slams has British tennis star Andy Murray won over the course of his career?
Three.
Correct. Three.
Three or four in my head. Is that what you were debating, Pitch? Or were you?
No, I'm debating two or three.
Two or three.
Yeah.
If we take the average of what you guys were debating. And on the answer, congratulations, Pitch. In this battle, you have won 7 points to 4. A very diplomatic, graceful, gentlemanly response with no sarcasm from Paul Drinkhall. So on the leaderboard, Pitch, a strong performance. Paul, you were very fun to watch.
Yeah. Thanks. That's when you know you've been great in a quiz. You were fun to watch.
Great effort.
Yeah.
Your potential is amazing.
Yeah, thank you, Adam.
Yeah. Okay, we've got two more questions here. These come from the fans. So,
see if we can answer these.
I think you'll be fine on these. Paul, I'll let
blue
you...
Blue whale!
It is blue whale. That is to this fan's question. So, Ethan with no A, ETH_N16 says, how do you stay motivated in rough patches or after poor results? Paul?
I think it should come to me, shouldn't it? It's very difficult when you lose on a quiz 7-4 like that and just get hit out of the park. You know, I think it's almost time for me to retire from the quiz game. on the table tennis. From the quiz game?
No, from table tennis. That's what I
apparently. Yeah, loads of people, yeah. So maybe quizzes I'll retire if it gets difficult. But table tennis, I think for me they're kind of the fun times, as strange as it sounds. I think when you're playing well and doing well, obviously everything's good and feels good in that way, but there's still a lot of challenges there. But for me, if you hit a rough patch and things, I think I really enjoy the challenge of finding a way and figuring a way out to get back to where you want to be and playing how you want to play. And again, I think that's something I've thought about, is if I can see people when they're getting towards the end of their career, they don't like that challenge anymore. And I think then that becomes the time when they start to think, you know, maybe I need to figure something else out or search for different things. But for me, that's the really fun part. It's fun working things out as such. Obviously, you have days where you really don't want to do anything and it's very difficult to do it. But again, as a whole package, I think you've got to look at it as enjoying the challenge.
Good answer. I like that. We accept it. So, no, okay. Mitch, how about you?
Yeah, I like that, Paul. 7-5. Now.
Thanks, Mitch.
I think, obviously, it's very difficult to, you know, if you lose a few matches and you get sort of down in a place where, you know, you're struggling to find answers with your game. I think for me, I found when I sort of like trusted my process and what I was doing in practice, when I learned to sort of trust that process and realise, you know, right now results don't matter as much. It's where you want to be, say, in 6 months or a year. And when you look towards that more, I think it's a lot easier, like Paul said, working towards something. Like, because, you know, everybody loses matches, even the best players in the world lose a lot of matches. It's how you sort of learn from those. You take away what you've done wrong, what you need to do better, and go back to practice and work on it. And like Paul said, that is the, maybe not so much the fun part, but that's where, you know, the magic happens for you to win matches in the future.
Well said. Valuable words from both sides. And yeah, good to know. All right. Final question from our fans. For Tainted Sorrow wants to know, why did you guys choose ping pong? Let's start with you, Pitch.
Why? I used to play tennis when I was young. Football and tennis were sort of my main sports. I played tennis to quite an okay level when I was sort of around 8, 9, 10 years old. And then one day at school, it was raining outside, we couldn't play football, so I went in. They had a table tennis sort of lunchtime club, and me and a couple of friends went along and started playing. I really enjoyed it and carried on playing, really. And then I had to sort of make a decision between table tennis and tennis, which one I wanted to sort of take seriously. And for me at that time, I just really enjoyed the social side of table tennis. It was a lot more sort of friendly than the tennis side. I had more friends in table tennis, and I decided to go with table tennis. Shut up, Paul.
What was that?
I said friends.
Friends?
Friends.
From In Between Us, I don't know if you've ever seen it.
Friends! Oh, my friend! Friends! Oh, friend. He's my friend! Oh, my friend!
And how about you, Polly D?
I was similar to Liam, used to play football and tennis. My brother played table tennis as well. He played them sports, and then we started table tennis at the same time, I think. And it came to the point where we had to choose. And I, if I'm honest, I don't know why I chose table. I know now why I chose table tennis, because of the spin involved and all the competition side of things. I really enjoy the table tennis. It's like a game of chess, trying to outthink your opponent, but with all the skills involved with a bat and ball as well. So I think that's why. But probably actually the time I just followed my big brother, true answer. Just he chose table tennis, so I followed.
Well, guys, it's been really fun. My cheeks hurt, but basically I laughed a lot. Before we go, Paul, let's start with you. Anything you want to say to your fans?
Keep being my fans. Thanks to everybody who supports me and supports table tennis. It's a great sport to be involved in, and I think everybody involved in it thinks it could be even greater. But without the fans from all levels and players from all levels, it wouldn't be possible. So keep going in the table tennis world.
Awesome. And Pitch, anything you'd like to say to fans?
Yeah, thanks for supporting. Keep following. Let's help grow table tennis to an even greater level than it already is, I think. So thank you.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, thank you guys both. This was super fun. Can't wait to see you guys again in person.
Yeah.
Take care.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Adam.
Yeah.
All right. Until next time, guys.
See you later.
Friends.